Hi, I'm Craig Johnson, and I serve as the parish's youth minister. I help with confirmation prep and young adult ministry. In my life's journey, I've had a number of roles which have forced me to, get stretched thin a little bit or pulled in a number of different directions, being in a relationship, being married, just becoming a father recently, trying to help with the ministries as best I can. All of those are kind of taxing of my time, but they're all really important roles that pull me in different directions. But the backbone to all of it, the thing that makes it possible, that, you know, energizes me and helps me to see light and get clarity through it all is turning to God. Taking time for prayer, which isn't necessarily, you know, one type of spirituality or another. It could just simply be, for me, silence, slow down, capitalize on the, you know, commute that I have, and so that I could really focus on, you know, what the Lord's calling me to do in that moment next. You know, I live about an hour and 15 minutes from here, so it gives me a lot of time to think about my day, either, you know, how it's going to begin or how did it go. I take time to listen to, books on tape. Matthew Kelly is one of my favorites. I also take time to just pray to the Lord. You know, I know there's a lot of people who have asked for my prayers. I hear the petitions of our young people at our gatherings, you know, and I give them to him for the day. November 30th was a pretty remarkable day. That's the day that my little girl, Ava Grace, was born. And, you know, the week leading up to that, you know, we knew that at any moment this could happen. She was 8 days late, so it was really like 2 weeks of trying to be prepared for this next moment in my life. And I'll say it's not always easy doing what God asks you to do. For me, it was making sure that the weekend's events that we were going to have happening here were all taken care of. It's like, you know, I was where I needed to be in that moment. I needed to also focus on my vocation as dad, as husband, to be there with my wife, who amazingly made it through that snowstorm. We got lodged in traffic for about 7.5 hours. And ended up having to stay at a hotel that was about 40 minutes from our house in a regular commute. So God's journey kind of is twisty and windy at times. You don't really understand it all. But the constant in all that is focusing on what does he want you to do in this moment. And then there's a little responsibility that says, you know, I have to kind of balance my own life's priorities as well. This has been a particularly busy month for me. We've had, you know, confirmation sessions, we've had youth ministry gatherings, we've had an Antioch reunion, we have a homeless overnight coming up, we have our Piano Man fundraiser, which is really exceptional for our youth mission trips, you know, and all the correspondences that go with those things. And there were moments, for sure, these last couple weeks where I've had to take a breath, step back, maybe just go to the chapel and pray a little bit. Just so that I don't get overwhelmed by all of that. And my life's calling, you know, God's calling for me has been unique. I think everybody's story is a little unique on that. If you asked me 10, 15 years ago, where would I be today? I couldn't possibly have told you that. When I was in high school, my family was pretty religious or spiritual. I belonged to a number of different prayer groups. And some of the people in those groups saw a young, aspiring, active Catholic. And they said, you know, you're going to be a priest. And, you know, why not? Why not? It's a great thing. We need priests. So I pursued, you know, discerning the priesthood right after high school. Thought maybe that was my call. And it wasn't. But it wasn't that I wasn't doing God's plan. I know that sounds confusing, but God wanted me to go to that seminary, even though priesthood wasn't the calling he had for me. While I was there, God introduced me to catechesis. I was teaching 5th and 6th grade kids at local parishes. We were doing door-to-door missions. He was reaching out to me on a spiritual level and teaching me to take time for prayer and silence, to invest in the sense of community that was present in the seminary where I was. So that way, when I would leave to move on to find the next step in God's plan for me, I would be equipped with all those tools. So the next step in my journey was really just getting involved in volunteer work. until that ended up becoming a more full-time position for me, and then becoming an educator in religious education and Catholic theology. Until one day it became evident that, in order for me to do this better, I have to go back and work on my own education as well. So, atypically from what most people do, the college career started long after I had graduated high school. There's a group called St. Paul's Outreach, and I worked with them to draw young people closer to relationship with Christ. And they have kind of like a five-step formula, which was reach out to somebody, give them an invitation to find something deeper in their life, call them to get involved, form, instruct, show them by example the ways that they can grow in their relationship with God, and then send. And, that might be St. Paul's Outreach's specific formula, but it's really the formula that Christ has for all of us. He reaches us on a daily basis. He's forming us constantly. Sometimes we don't understand those valleys we're going through, but they're formative. And he's sending us out into the fields on a daily basis. Every step of the way has got, it's got an intentional part to it. God doesn't do things by accident, and I might not know what he has in store for me tomorrow or 2 years or 10 years from now, but I know right now I'm right where he wants me to be.